Hello everyone, in this video, we will talk about the SOLIDWORKS assembly. There are two ways to make an assembly. First one is by directly opening new assembly file and add parts. Other is to create an assembly from part. I made this part and now to create an assembly, click on arrow near new document icon, then select make assembly from part or assembly. In assembly, we assemble different part or assembly to create a machine or any product. I have inserted these two parts. You can add multiple parts using insert components option. The first inserted part in an assembly is always fixed, which is denoted by F in the design tree, while we can move every other part which is denoted by minus sign in the design tree. Now let's assemble or join different parts. I have inserted these four parts and to join them, we use mate feature. Just select the dimension and set mate which are similar to relations. I made the upper face of block and cuboid coincident, that is in same plane. Usually, SOLIDWORKS automatically identifies the condition and set mate. Mate is of different types, standard, advanced, analysis and mechanical, but I will be covering the standard mates as these are commonly used. You will see that cuboid is still moving but in same plane, and to fix it inside that cavity, we have to use more mates. First, let's make the vertices coincident. It is still movable, so we will coincident another vertex and now our cuboid is fixed. You will also notice that the minus symbol in front of cuboid is also gone, which means that its position is fully defined. There is a move component feature which is used to move parts, and below it there is rotate component which is used to rotate parts. Similarly, let's fix the other two shapes and it's done. For next example, I inserted a block and a cylinder, but I need three cylinders. There is a very useful shortcut in SOLIDWORKS to copy parts. Press and hold Ctrl key, then drag the part. A copy of that part will be automatically created. Now let's fix the cylinder in block using previous mates. You will notice that we fixed its position, but it is still rotating. You can leave it at that if your final product has movable parts. Otherwise, there is a way to fix the rotation. Select one of the side of hexagonal cavity and any face of block, then make them parallel. Now the cylinder is fixed. Same mate on the other cylinder, then let's make it parallel to the right face and done. As for third cylinder, we will make it tangent to one side and coincident to top face, then we can rotate it on side like this. Now if you want to remove any mates, click on arrow near mates in the design tree and here you will see all the mates. To remove a mate, select it and press delete, then yes. We can also remove a mate by right clicking on a part and select view mates option, then delete the mate. You can also hide and unhide mates by right clicking. Next, we will see angles and distance mate. I inserted a base and four wings. First, we will connect a wing to right side vertex, and as you can see, it only moves circular. To fix the angle, select the upper faces of both base and wing, then click on angle. Note that this angle is between two faces. And done. Similarly, set the other wing. Now we will set this wing straight on top. After setting up, this wing can move on the surface. To fix this at a certain distance, select the face and vertex, then set distance. This will fix the wing. You can also set distance between two faces. Now, final mate type, which is lock. Select any two parts and click on lock. This will lock the part with respect to other. And when you move one part, the other will also move with it. So this was the complete SOLIDWORKS assembly guide. You can use it to make different machines, or if you have a capable PC, then you can even make a car and simulate it. See you in the next one.